From a tiny garden shed to in New Zealand to the John Oliver TV show in New York, a New Zealand business, Metal Birds, has been on quite the journey.
Here is last year's sculpture of the triumphant Rock Ran. Would you like to see the sculpture they've made for this year's winner? Because here it is, a magnificent Pūteketeke win. As you can see, me riding on its back like one of its babies.
That is a real thing. We have it in the studio this morning. Pūteketeke is the latest creation thanks to its triumphant Bird of the Century win. Here to tell us about the story behind it all is Metal Bird founder Phil Walters. Thank you so much for being with us. This is fantastic. And I can't wait to hear the story behind this one in particular. But can you just take me back to the start of this journey? How did this all begin for you?
Metal Bird started about 12 years ago as a graffiti street art project in Grey Lynn, where I was making small birds in my shed by hand and hammering them into local lampposts and buildings, really just to kind of intrigue my neighbours. And, you know, a great activity with my kids who were then about 9 and 11. And it's kind of gone from there to the point where we set up a small, well, I set up a small business in New Zealand in around 2010. And we've since gone on to take the business global to, I think we're currently in 8 countries.
Incredible. Mm. And then about 5 years ago, you decided to start this partnership with Forest and Bird, right?
Yeah, well, Forest and Bird has always been on my list of people to work with. And it's quite a luxury to have a business that you can give back to, you know, to important causes. So, yeah, for the last 5 or so years, we at Metal Bird have been waiting for the bird of the year and then quickly designing a sculpture of it and selling it and directing profits towards Forest and Bird.
And when you say quickly, you mean really quickly?
Typically in a day. You know, we would have done the last two, we would have done a bit of prep design on and have them ready to go. And then quickly we get into sampling and manufacture and get it up on the website and start selling them so that they can raise money while it's topical.
Does Forest and Bird give you any kind of a heads up ahead of time as to who might be winning, who you should design the bird for?
Typically, you start to see the stats.
Yeah.
You can do it. I mean, this was
a runaway
this year
success.
Was a luxury because we kind of knew what was coming at us.
So this year, obviously, you had to design the Pūteketeke, but as we saw in that clip, you went one step further. You designed a John Oliver figurine to clip onto its back.
Yeah.
Was that your decision to do that? Did you come up with that creative concept?
Listen, I don't know where it came from in the team, but I think the opportunity was there, given the nature of his intervention and the mischief that he created. We had to do something, right?
Totally.
We had to do something tongue-in-cheek. So the Pūteketeke sculpture was kind of business as usual, and it was luxurious in the regard that we had a lot of time to put it together, but adding the John Oliver clip-on was really just a little nod to...
it's so good. We were just seeing some of the footage of the process there. How easy is it to make these things? Talk me through the process.
It's a lot easier now that we are using industrial laser cutting processes around the world. So fundamentally, my role in it is the design of the product and optimizing. I'm an industrial designer, so I'm kind of used to making stuff. But the hard part is kind of getting the design right. So you're capturing the gesture of the bird and that everyone's happy with it. And at the end of the day, you want something that people want to buy. And in this instance, we really want somebody we want to buy because we really want to lean into the fundraising for Forest and Bird.
And how's it going? I mean, typically, you obviously would sell a few of these, like a fair few of these, when you commission a Forest and Bird.
Yeah,
piece.
I'd say it's going well.
How well compared to usual years?
Like really well.
Yeah. Can you talk to me about numbers?
I mean, it doesn't hurt when you get one of the biggest, I guess, late night shows in the world promoting your product and sticking your URL up on his show that's being repeated every 6 hours.
Yeah.
So we're selling them by the thousands at the moment in the USA, and it's starting to ripple through the rest of the world with regard to the markets that are interested, like New Zealand and perhaps the UK.
Can you keep up with demand?
we're scrambling. We're absolutely scrambling at the moment to keep up with demand. But we'll get there. So, you know, it's a big time of year for us with regard to Black Friday, Cyber Monday, Christmas, Boxing Day, and now the bird of the century.
Brilliant. It's so good. Congratulations on all the success, especially from those humble beginnings. And your daughter's involved in the company now as well.
Well, she just finished her business degree, business and marketing degree, and it's thankfully she's joined us, come back up from Otago. She's been working in the business since she was 9 years old. So
brilliant.
She's pretty good.
And people can get these from metalbird.co.nz.
Yeah, the New Zealand website's probably the easiest one. They're available, obviously, in the States as well, but www.metalbird.co.nz is where to go.
Phil Walters, the founder of Metalbird, thank you so much for coming in. You're congratulations.
Welcome.
It's
thank
so
you.
Cool.